We are asked to multiply and simplify if possible. Here we have a whole number times a mixed number. We can view 3 times 2 and 5, 6 as meaning 3 copies or 3 groups of 2 and 5, 6. We will first determine the product using the formal rules outlined below, but then we'll take a look at a model to better understand the product. The first step is to convert the mixed numbers and whole numbers to improper fractions, which means you write 3 as a fraction with the denominator of 1. So we have 3 over 1 times. Now we convert 2 and 5, 6 to an improper fraction. The denominator remains 6. To determine the numerator, we multiply the denominator and the whole number, and then add the numerator. 6 times 2 is 12. 12 plus 5 equals 17. 2 and 5, 6 equals 17 sixths. Next, we multiply the numerators and denominators. The numerator is 3 times 17. The denominator is 1 times 6. Before we determine these products, though, we will simplify out any common factors between the numerator and denominator. Notice 3 and 6 share a common factor of 3. There's 1 3 and 3, and 2 3s and 6. The only remaining common factor between the numerator and denominator is 1, so now we can multiply knowing the product will be in simplified form. 1 times 17 is 17, and 1 times 2 is equal to 2. The product as an improper fraction is 17 halves, which is in simplified form. But let's also express the improper fraction as a mixed number. A fraction bar means division, and therefore to convert 17 halves to a mixed number, we divide 17 by 2. There are 8 twos in 17. 8 times 2 equals 16. Subtract, the difference is 1, which gives us a quotient of 8 and 1 half. To form the fraction, it is always the remainder over the divisor. So the product is 17 halves as an improper fraction, or 8 and 1 half as a mixed number. And now let's take a look at a model for this product to better understand why the product equals 8 and a half. Again, viewing this product as 3 copies or 3 groups of 2 and 5, 6, we would have the model shown below. Notice where if the rectangle is 1 unit, here we have 1 copy of 2 and 5, 6, 2 copies, and 3 copies. Now let's determine how much we have here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now here we have 5 sixths. One more sixth would give us 6 sixths, or 1. So 5 sixths plus this 1 sixth gives us another unit, which would be 7. And here we have 4 sixths plus 2 sixths here would give us 6 sixths, or another 1, which gives us 8. And then here we have 3 sixths, which we can see is equivalent to 1 half. This model shows why the product equals 8 and a half, or if we want 17 halves. I hope you found this helpful.